Imagine living your entire life on the water without ever setting foot on land. For the Bajau people, this is not a fantasy, but a reality. The Bajau are a nomadic ethnic group that inhabits the waters of Southeast Asia, especially the Philippines, Malaysia, and Indonesia. They are also known as sea nomads or sea gypsies for their unique way of life that revolves around the ocean. The Bajau have adapted to the marine environment in remarkable ways. They live in stilt houses or wooden boats called lepa that they use as their homes and transport. They subsist on fishing, seaweed farming, and trading with other coastal communities. They have developed exceptional skills in free diving, holding their breath for up to 13 minutes and diving as deep as 200 feet. They use simple tools such as spears, nets, and goggles made from wood and glass to hunt for fish and other sea creatures. They also have a special relationship with the sea, respecting its bounty and its dangers, and following its rhythms and seasons. But how did the Bajau become so attuned to the water? And what challenges do they face in the modern world? To answer these questions, we need to explore their history, culture, and biology. The Bajau are believed to have originated from the Sulu archipelago in the southern Philippines, where they were once part of the Sultanate of Sulu, a powerful maritime state that ruled over the region from the 15th to the 19th century. The Bajau served as the Sultan's loyal warriors, sailors and traders, and were granted autonomy and privileges in exchange for their loyalty. However, when the Spanish colonized the Philippines in the 16th century, they disrupted the political and economic order of the Sultanate, and the Bajau were forced to flee from the oppression and violence. Some of them settled in the coastal areas of Mindanao, the second largest island in the Philippines, while others migrated to the neighboring islands of Borneo and Sulawesi, where they found refuge and new opportunities. The Bajau's migration and dispersion across the seas led to their diversification into different subgroups, each with their own dialect, customs, and traditions. Some of the subgroups are the Sama Dilaut, the Sama Palau, the Sama Kota, and the Sama Bangingi. The Sama Dilaut, or the sea people, are the most nomadic and aquatic of the Bajau, living almost exclusively on their lepa boats and rarely venturing on land. The Sama Palau, or the island people, are semi-nomadic, living in stilt houses on coral reefs and islands and moving from place to place depending on the season and the availability of resources. The Sama Kota, or the city people, are more sedentary, living in permanent settlements on the mainland and engaging in trade and commerce with other ethnic groups. The Sama Bangingi, or the people of the East, are the most isolated and conservative of the Bajau, living in remote islands and maintaining their traditional way of life. Despite their differences, the Bajau share a common identity and heritage based on their language, religion, and affinity with the sea. The Bajau speak various dialects of the Sama Bajau language, which belongs to the Austronesian language family, the same family that includes languages such as Malay, Indonesian, Tagalog, and Hawaiian. The Bajau are predominantly Muslim, having converted to Islam in the 16th century under the influence of the Sultanate and the Arab traders. However, they also retain some of their pre-Islamic beliefs and practices, such as animism, ancestor worship, and shamanism. The Bajau regard the sea as their home and their source of life, and they have developed a rich and complex cosmology and mythology around it. They believe that the sea is inhabited by various spirits, such as the Ombo Dilaut, the Lord of the Sea, and the Umang, the guardian of the coral reefs. They also believe that their ancestors, the Panglima Laut, the sea warriors, and the Tun Sakaran, the founder of the Sultanate, watch over them and protect them from harm. The Bajau's adaptation to the water is not only cultural, but also biological. Recent studies have shown that the Bajau have evolved larger spleens than their land-dwelling neighbors, which gives them an advantage in diving. The spleen is an organ that stores oxygen-rich red blood cells, and when a person dives, the spleen contracts and releases these cells into the bloodstream, increasing the oxygen supply and allowing the diver to stay underwater longer. The Bajau's larger spleens are the result of a genetic mutation that affects a hormone called thyroid-stimulating hormone, or TSH, which regulates the growth and function of the spleen. The Bajau have higher levels of TSH than other populations, which leads to their enlarged spleens. This mutation is believed to have occurred about 1,000 years ago, when the Bajau first started their seafaring lifestyle. The Bajau's remarkable way of life, however, is under threat from various factors such as environmental degradation, climate change, overfishing, poverty, and marginalization. The Bajau's traditional fishing grounds are being depleted by commercial fishing, pollution, and coral bleaching, which reduce the fish stocks and damage the marine ecosystems. The Bajau's nomadic lifestyle is also being challenged by the changing weather patterns, rising sea levels, and natural disasters, such as typhoons and tsunamis, which make the water more unpredictable and dangerous. The Bajau's economic and social status is also precarious, as they face discrimination and exploitation from the governments and the dominant ethnic groups of the countries they live in. The Bajau are often denied citizenship, land rights, education, healthcare, and legal protection, and are subjected to harassment, violence, and displacement. The Bajau's culture and identity are also eroding, as they are pressured to assimilate to the mainstream society, abandon their traditions, and adopt a more modern and urban lifestyle. The Bajau are a fascinating and resilient people who have survived and thrived in the water for centuries. They have a unique and valuable knowledge and wisdom about the ocean and a deep and respectful connection with nature. They are also a vulnerable and endangered people who need recognition, support, and protection from the threats they face. The Bajau are a living testament to the diversity and adaptability of the human species and a reminder of the beauty and fragility of the water that sustains us all.